सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदागुश्च प्रीणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्य बुद्धिर्दृक्यत्ननिर्वरम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्योन्नति मे निश्चितामतिः। You have to look at the tippana. I think you're looking at the tippana, Wendy. You had failure in Google. So the options as to what is this Chidabhasa really is being seen. So initially we saw this Darpanadehe Bhayatvat. So basically Ghatapatadi can also be jiva if you misunderstand the jada antakarana jiva. Then there was a progression of counters to purva paksha as to know interior, reflecting medium, then interior and so on, swachha, reflecting medium, swachhatva. So aswachhatvat ghatadehe tanna sambhavati. Then that is not true because darpana will be jiva now. Darpana can also become jiva if you say swachha, swachhatvat antakkaranam jivaha. Antakkaranasya swachhatvat antakkaranam jivaha. If you give that kind of a reasoning, then darpana can also be jiva. And then antaratvat indriyapekshaya. So then Bahyatvat, if his arpana is bahya, then antaratvat antakkaranam jivaha. If you give that kind of a logic, then indriya. Indriya can also be jiva. But then compared to indriya, antakkarana is further interior. If you say it is more antara, antara taratvat, then what will happen is that Karana Sharira, Avidya can also become Jiva. So this was the reason, logical reasoning given by the Purva Pakshi, which was refuted because of Shushka Tarka. Shushka Tarka can be refuted by Shushka Tarka itself because Tarka can go either way. There has to be some grounding, some foundation, which is Siddha, which is agreeable to both parties. Then only discussion is possible in the first place. If you just use tarka, then anyone can use any tarka. As long as you follow the tarka rules, you are okay. Now, someone used to say law is like that. Law arguments are like that. But then you have to trace it back to the rule book. The book of law, you have to trace it back to either the constitution in the case of, the context. Or the criminal law, whatever it is, civil law, you have to be able to trace back to a rule book which is agreeable to everyone. Otherwise, the arguments of lawyers can twist things the way they want. Similarly, tarka is also like that. So somebody gave a comparison of law with chapati, roti. So you can flip it either way and still bake it, still cook it. So this is like that. Law is also like that, and so is tarka like that, but the foundation for darshana has to be Vedas, Vedanta. And although we use tarka, our tarka, Vedantic tarka, traces back to Shruti. We don't mind using any tarka, any which way, as long as the conclusion lands on the Shruti. Thereby, what is the Siddhanta? What does the Shruti say? Chetanatvam. Jiva should have Chetanatvam. Chetanatva deva na achetanasya antakranasya jivatvam ghatate. Then, kevala pratibimbasya api na jivatvam sambhavati, it was refuted because antakrana rupa upadhi mantara pratibimba yoga. Pratibimbasya yoga. You cannot have pratibimba without there being some upadhi where there is this pratibimba, and that upadhi happens to be antakarana. Then you put them together. If you put them together, what will happen? Adhishthana chaitanyasya jivattukti rasangata. No, sorry, just the before you put them together, adhishthana chaitanasya. Adhishthana chaitana. If chaitanatvam is needed for jiva, then adhishthana chaitanya is chaitana anyway. How about that being jiva? That is not possible. Because nirvikaratvat vikaratmaka jivatvam na yujyate. Jiva undergoes a lot of vikaras. Every karaka will undergo vikaras. Jiva is karta bhokta. So kartru karaka or karma karaka. By becoming a bhokta, he is a karta as well. But if he is objectified by others, he thinks that I am objectified by others, he can become karma. Then by saying that things are taking place in me, he can become adhikarana. If he becomes a means, he becomes karana. So if he is a source, then he will become upadana. If he is a recipient, he becomes sampradana. Then he has sambandha with others. If not a karaka, there will be sambandha. Sambandha may not necessarily change a person, really, but then still, sambandha can bring in some association, that by association there will be change. That association itself is a change because it will mean avayavattvam. There will be parts. So all karakas and even sambandha also, shashti, sambandhe shashti, all these can bring about changes. However, atma, chaitanya is nirvikara. So nirvikaratva tasya chaitanyasya vikaratmaka jivattam na yujyate. Jiva who undergoes all types of vikaras, therefore he is a samsari. So vikara can also be seen shad vikaras. I just explained vyakrana wise changes, but then shad vikara asti jayate, then vardhate, viparinivate, apakshiyate, and then mriyate. Shad vikara, six vikaras are there. Jiva undergoes through all those. Jiva is born. This is a thinking. Jiva brahmahiva na paraha. If that is the understanding, Jiva is not born. There, Chaitanya is Jiva. But here the discussion is not Jiva as Brahma. Not Aikya Vichara. This is the definition of Jiva. Who is a samsari Jiva? There you cannot say Chaitanya is Jiva. Of course, Vedantins will say, of course, Ishvara, Brahma, Ishvara, Jiva are all in Samana Adhikarana. However, technical analysis, when you are talking about Vadas, there you cannot bring in this equation and say something which is a conclusion, which is not agreeable to other parties. You cannot just land on the conclusion and start there. Then there is no discussion possible. It is a statement. You agree with my paksha, which is this Shruti Paksha. If you do not agree, I don't care. That is fine. But then discussion is not possible. So, Vikaratmaka Jivattam na yujyate. You have to explain technically who is this Jiva. He cannot be Chaitanya. Why? Samsaritvat also. Vikaratvam itself is samsara. Then fourth Paksha is Pratibimba Vishittantakranam Jivastu iti chenna. We saw this kalpitatva vishesha jivasya nityatva siddhu mukta bhava prasangat. I'm just gathering it because we'll lose count. we've seen this yesterday, and somewhere when you're looking at Bhagatyaga Lakshana, there was a disconnect. So Pratibimba Vishitta Antakaranam Jivaha, both put together, Pratibimba and Antakarana put together, let us call that as Jiva. That's not true. Why? Pratibimba as well as Antakarana are both Kalpita, are both Maya products. That much we can say, they are Kalpita or Vikshepa. So that feature being common, Pratibimba will go. It is not Sat. What does it mean, Kalpita? It is not Sat. It will not linger on forever. It has come up in time. It will go away in time. As soon as the Upadhi goes, Pratibimba will also cease to be. So Agantuka Pratibimba and Agantuka Antakkarana, thereby, if Jiva is Pratibimba and Antakkarana put together, then Jiva will vanish when Pratibimba goes or Antakkarana goes. But both are bound to go. When Antakkarana goes away, Pratibimba will also go away. Jiva will go away. If Jiva goes away, who will get Mukti? So Nityatva Siddhau, since Pratibimba is not Nitya, Antakkarana is not Nitya, Mukta Abhava Prasangat. Mukta Abha, Muktasya Abhava Prasangat. There will be no Mukta at all. If there is no Mukta, then why struggle for Shravana Mana Nididhyasana? No use. Kincha, this is what we are looking at. This is a technical point. Bhagatyaga Lakshana Asambhava Nikhila Vachya Bhagatyaga Rupa Jahal Lakshana Eva Siddhyet. What will happen is that Jahal Lakshana, you will be ending up using Jahal Lakshana. Still you can, you know, in equation, in Mimamsa, Shabda Mimamsa, if you are doing Pratibimba Vishishta Antakkaranam Jeevaha Saha Jeevaha Tvam Padartha Vachyarthaha. If you take that and then Tattvamasi, when you are analyzing, that time you have got Pratibimba Vishishta Antakkaranam as Tvampada, then Ishvara on the other side as Tatpada. What can you do then? Ishvara, you do Bhagatyaga Lakshana on the Pada. You hold on to Chaitanya on the right hand side, Ishvara, or left hand side, Tattvamasi. So Tat is left hand side, Tvam is right hand side. Tat you will be able to analyze by Bhagatyaga Lakshana or Jahad Ajal Lakshana. You give up whatever is contradictory to Alpatvam of Jiva. The Sarvajnyatvam of Ishvara is contradictory. The Virat Sharira is contradictory to small Sharira of Alpa Sharira of Jiva. You put them aside. But here you have Pratibimba Vishishta Antakaranam Jivaha. Then at the Pratibimba level, Ishvara has a Pratibimba which is Hairanyagarbha Rupa Pratibimba, which is the Pratibimba in all Antakkaranas, a huge, unthinkable, not only human beings, every Jiva, every sentient being has Pratibimba. That Pratibimba is huge if you compare with the individual. So that Pratibimba, you have to set it aside. It is so unthinkably big. We can't even imagine tending to infinity kind of Bhratvam of the Pratibimba. Antakkarana also, since Antakkaranas are, as many Antakkaranas are there, so many Jivas are there, really. So Antakkaranas are also many, again tending to infinity. So you have to give that up also. So you do that on the left hand side for Ishvara. On right hand side, if you do that, left hand side you have got Satchidananda Vastu left. After you give up all contradictory things. If you give up all contradictory things on the right hand side, nothing will be left. Shunya. You cannot use Bhagatyaga Lakshana. So what do you have to do? You have to use, here he says, Jahal Lakshana Eva Siddhye. If you give up, you'll have to give up the main meaning. Main meaning of Jiva, as per this definition, would be Pratibimba Vishishta Antakkarana. You have to give up the Pratibimba meaning also, Antakkarana meaning also, because both put together are Jiva. You have to give up the entire meaning and then take a related meaning, which is neither Pratibimba nor Antakkarana, but something related, which makes this sentient, which is the कूटस्थ चैतन्य. सो दैट विल बी जहद लक्षण. यू कैन लैंड ऑन इट बट इट विल बी जहद लक्षण ऑन वन साइड एंड ईदर भागत्याग लक्षण ऑन तत्पदार्थ और इट विल बी जहल लक्षण देर ऑल्सो. यू कैन यूज जहल लक्षण ऑन दि तत्पदार्थ एंड जहल लक्षण ऑन दि त्वम पदार्थ एंड लैंड ऑन दि ऐक्य. विच इज वॉट आई वॉज सेइंग इज ओके बिकॉज भगवान नैष्कर्म्य सिद्धिकार हैज शोन. आई रिकॉल इट वन प्लेस ही हैज यूज इनिशियली दैट यू कैन लैंड ऑन ऐक्य थ्रू जहल लक्षण ऑल्सो. बट दि तर्क तर्कशास्त्र logically whatever is not divorced from the statement more or whatever is closer to the samanya artha of the sentence that should be taken. So in comparison between jahad ajal lakshana and jahal lakshana, jahad ajal lakshana is shreshtha. Why? Because it holds on to part meaning. It does not give up the complete meaning. It takes something related. It holds on to the part meaning on both sides. So it is shreshtha. That is why bhyagatyaga lakshana or jahad ajal lakshana is used. It is superior to jahal lakshana. In fact, jahal lakshana is bahuduram. In comparison, even ajahal lakshana will be shreshtha because ajahal lakshana also you don't give up the primary meaning and then add on another meaning. So primary meaning is there plus an additional visheshana or something is brought in, or visheshana is there, you bring in the substantive, you drag in the substantive. So rakto gachati, rakto gachati, the red is going, red is a visheshana to something. What is it? Rakta ashva gachati, it's a horse who is going. So there that will also be shreshta compared to jahal lakshana. But I was saying that is all technicality. If you can land on the aikya any which way, it is convincing to you, it takes away your doubts, it is too personal to you, do not bother about whether it is in sync with the superiority of analysis or inferiority of analysis. Don't think about that at all. If you can land on the aikya, that prakriya is good for you. It is a sadhu prakriya. Yaya yaya prakriya yaya yaya bhavet pumsam. I think nishtha or something, pratyagatmani. In pratyagatma, if you can land, which is brahma, sasaiva prakriya sadhvi. That is a sadhvi prakriya, sadhu. It is the not only sadhu, it is the best prakriya for you because you don't have to do anything more. You have already landed. Why would you want to learn something else? If you are interested, you do. But then it is not for moksha anymore. You already got moksha because you landed on jnana. Now, instead of wasting time in anything else, you can hold on to that. That is all I was saying yesterday. Tikakaras also put the effort for the same reason, to help out somebody who is missing something in the bhashya. They give another way out. Can you reach there? The goal of Bhagavan Bhashyakara is to see that you reach there. He does not care by which means you reach. As long as you hold on to Shruti, he is okay with any prakriya. That is why Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya wrote in his presence itself, he has written the Brihat Vartika. Huge Vartika. Imagine 10,000 shlokas for Upodghata. For Bhagavan Bhashyakara's Upodghata, he has got 10,000, 12,000 verses. Then Brihadaranyaka itself is a lifelong study. Imagine Vartika on that. Anyway, I may be wrong in numbers. Maybe 10,000 verses for the entire thing, and then 10% of that is Upodghata. So I'm not good with numbers and names, so you'll have to forgive me there. Anyway, so किंच भागत्याग लक्षण असंभवात निखिल वाच्य भागत्याग रूप जल लक्षण एव सिद्धेत न च एतद् भाष्यकार अभिमतम. भाष्यकार डज नॉट अभिमतम, इट्स ही डज नॉट इंटेंड दैट. ही मे नॉट इंटेंड इट बट हिज इंटेंशन इज वॉट रियली यू डिग इन टू भाष्यकार इंटेंशन, इट इज फॉर यू टू गेट गेट ऐक्य ज्ञान बट टेक्निकली ही डिडंट इंटेंडेड देयरफॉर भागत्याग लक्षण इज श्रेष्ठ विद दिस प्रोसेस ऑल्दो यू कैन लैंड इट इज नॉट वॉट भगवान भाष्यकार इंटेंडेड ही नोज श्रुति इन एंड आउट देयरफॉर यू शुड होल्ड ऑन टू भाष्य एज मच एज पॉसिबल यू विल नॉट गो रॉन्ग thereby अपि च अधिष्ठानात् अप्रतग्भूतं सत् यद् अधिष्ठानम् आवृणोति तदेव आरोप्यम् इत्युच्यते further what further there is there may be dosha अधिष्ठानात् अप्रतग्भूतं what should be negated आरोपित should be negated अध्यासा should be negated now अध्यासा what is अध्यासा और आरोपित आरोप्य आरोपित आरोप्य व्हाट इज इट अधिष्ठानात् अपृथग्भूतम् सत् व्हाट इज नॉन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अधिष्ठान अपृथग्भूतम् सत् यद् अधिष्ठानम् आवृणोति व्हाट इज रियली नॉट डिफरेंट इट इज नॉन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अधिष्ठान मीनिंग इट कैन बी गुणगुणी भाव ऑल्सो But it veils the adhisthana. Veil tadeva aropyam ityuchyate. That is called as aropyam. How so? Now look at the Rajju Sarpa example also. Is Sarpa really different from Rajju? There is no presence of Sarpa at all. Sarpa is a projection which comes up and when refuted where does it go it goes only in the adhisthana sarpa has come up due to avidya or ajnana where is ajnana it is in the adhisthana chaitanya really now this adhisthana chaitanya having ajnana can we separate out and show ajnana we cannot show it just like agni ushnavat अग्नेहे उष्ण उष्णम यदस्ति कैन यू शो इट एज डिफरेंट यू कैन नॉट शो इट दिस इज अ रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ अ तार्किक गुण एंड गुणी आर सेपरेट देसे एंड गुण गुणी हैव संबंध समवाय संबंध देयर दी सिद्धांति नास्सिम शो मी व्हाट इज गुण कैन यू शो मी गुण सेपरेट फ्रॉम दी गुणी कैन यू शो मी दी गुणी सेपरेट फ्रॉम दी गुण यू कैन नॉट So whenever guna is seen, wherever there is ushnata seen, there agni is always there. And they are not separate padarthas per se, you cannot show them at all. Unlike, you know, dhuma and agni. Yatra yatra dhumaha tatra tatra vannihi. There you can show dhuma is separate, vanni is separate. You can see dhuma, you have to do anuman of vanni. But vanni is separate because you can see dhuma separately. But that is not true between guna and guni. Guna cannot be seen separately from guni. Ushna cannot be seen without agni. Agni is there wherever there is ushna. You don't have to say that, agni is not there, but there is this guna of ushnatvam. Cannot say that. So there is no difference between the two. Similarly, avidya, which is never seen separate from chetana because adhishtana is there. That is the meaning of अपिच अधिष्ठानात् अपृथग्भूतं सत् यद् अधिष्ठानम् आवृणोति तदेव आरोप्यम् इत्युच्यते दैट इज द आरोप्यम् सो अविद्या इज आल्सो आरोपित आरोप्य एंड देयर कार्य आल्सो अविद्या कार्य इज आल्सो आरोप्य दैट इज विक्षेप नहि अधिष्ठानमंतरा पृथग् आरोप्यम् कुत्रापि अवभासते नेवर डू यू सी एनीथिंग विदाउट इट्स अधिष्ठान बीइंग देयर इन द केस ऑफ आरोप्य अनेन अनुमानेन बुद्धि सहित चिदा भासः जीवः इति चेन्न सॉरी अनेन अनुमानेन बुद्धि सहित चिदाभासो जीवः इति एतद् अपास्तम् सो व्हाट हैज टू बी एक्सेप्टेड इज दैट चैतन्य इज नेवर सेपरेट फ्रॉम दी प्रतिबिंब विशिष्ट अंतकरण और रादर प्रतिबिंब विशिष्ट अंतकरण अदर वे अराउंड प्रतिबिंब विशिष्ट अंतकरणम इज नेवर सेपरेट अपृथक भूतम दिस इज आरोप्य अपृथक भूतम फ्रॉम अपृथक भूत फ्रॉम चैतन्य देयरफॉर बुद्धि सहित चिदाभास जीव इति एतद् अपास्तम्। बुद्धि सहित चिदाभास, चिदाभास यू हैव टू टॉक अबाउट हु इज चिदाभास, चित इज ऑलरेडी देयर इन चिदाभास। फिफ्थ पक्ष अधिष्ठान चैतन्यम प्रतिबिंब चैतन्यं च इति उभयम् मिलित्वा जीव इति चेन्न। Then the other combination, Adhisthana Chaitanya has to be there. Okay, I agree. How about putting Pratibimba Chaitanya together with Adhisthana Chaitanya, meaning let alone Antakkarana? Why do you need Antakkarana? If you mix the other two, can that be Jiva? Iti chenna kevala chaitanyasya nirvikarataya kartrutva bhoktrutvadi vikaro upeta jivatva sambhavat. Why? Why can't you take that? Because Adhisthana Chaitanyam and Pratibimba Chaitanyam, both are Chaitanyam. Chaitanya, if you put two types of Chaitanyas together, whether one is reflecting or not is irrelevant. For you, it is Chaitanya. For you, for others also, it is Chaitanya. Because when you are saying Pratibimba Chaitanyam, you are not talking about Pratibimba, you are talking about Chaitanya itself. Therefore, two Chaitanyas, one Chaitanya cannot be Karta Bhokta. Now you put another Chaitanya, be it reflected, it also cannot be Karta Bhokta really. Kevala Chaitanya se nirvikaritaya kartrutva bhoktrutvadi vikaropeta jivatva sambhava. This refutation has been made earlier, not in the case of Pratibimba Chaitanya and Adhisthana Chaitanya put together, but only Adhisthana Chaitanya. You use the same tarka to refute that, same reasoning. Sixth paksha. अधिष्ठान चैतन्यम अंतःकरणम चेति उभयम् मिलित्वा जीव इति चेत्। देन व्हाई नॉट टेक अधिष्ठान चैतन्य एंड अंतःकरण, लेट अलोन दिस प्रतिबिंब। इन दैट पक्षा व्हाट इज द दोष? दर्पणम दर्पणाधिष्ठान चैतन्यम च मिलित्वा तर्हि जीवस्यात्। दर्पण इज देयर, मिरर इज देयर, ऑल्दो मिरर इज जड़ा, इट्स does not have antakkarana. Sharira is also jada. Antakkarana or buddhi, which is swachha, darpana is also swachha. However, the difference is antakkarana, the way the antakkarana is formed, it has some peculiar characteristic which makes it possible to come alive as though, become sentient. Darpana cannot be. So darpanam darpana adhisthana chaitanyam. So although chaitanya, which is all pervasive, is adhisthana for darpana as much as it is adhisthana for antakkarana, still antakkarana alone comes alive. Darpana does not come alive. Come alive is as though. Jivatvam, jiva bhava is there. Antakkarana makes it possible to think, to resolve issues, to become a karta bhokta. This is not possible in Darpana. So what is the difference? There is some difference. What is the difference? Pratibimba coming up there itself is the difference. Darpana and Darpana Adhisthana Chaitanya, it will be similar to this Antakkarana and Adhisthana Chaitanya coming together. So Antakkarana and Adhisthana Chaitanya put together, that is same as Darpana, which is also like Antakkarana, it is Jada. Adhisthana Chaitanya is common on both sides. So you replace Antakkarana with Darpana, does it come alive? It doesn't. So Jivatvam is not due to Jada Antakkarana and Adhisthana Chaitanya coming together. There is something unholy, you know, one Acharya of ours used to say this, unholy, you know. He used to say unholy because it is samsara karanam. It makes a person samsari. There is something specific. What is that specific? That specificity is due to something else being there. Along with this combination, there is something else. You can't miss it. That happens to be Pratibimba. Therefore, Darpanam Darpana Darpanadhisthana Chaitanyam cha Militva Tarhi Jivasyat Natu Tatha Asti. That is not possible. Tayoho Jivatva Na Sambhavati. Darpana and Darpana Adhisthana, because Adhisthana Chaitanya, you cannot say it is there only in Antakkarana. It is there even in Darpana Ityadi, Ghatapatadi. Darpana is used because it's a reflecting medium. Swachha. But it does not reflect Chaitanya. To reflect Chaitanya, you need a specific reflecting medium. Of course, I mean, at a very, very, very basic level, we can say Darpana may also be reflecting Chaitanya. But who is there to claim it? There has to be a claimant. That claimant kind of a characteristic is not there in that reflection, which it does not mix up. So, there is an assumption because actually the Pratibimba is also possible, explained at the level of Stula Sharira. Stula Sharira and Karana Sharira also there is reflection, but the thinking capacity, confusion is possible and thinking is possible, resolution is also possible only in the Antakkarana. Therefore, we qualify Antakkarana alone in the formulation of Jiva. We bring in Antakkarana, Sukshma Sharira. Stula Sharira also reflects because we have identification as Stula Sharira. Karana Sharira is also there because that is our Punji, that's our main asset for Samsara. Without Avidya being my asset, I cannot become a Samsari. I hold on to Avidya as mine. Therefore, I continue in Samsara. Therefore, Karana Sharira also reflects. But where is the Upalabdhi Sthana? Upalabdhi Sthana is Sukshma Sharira. In that Sukshma Sharira also Buddhi specifically. Therefore, Tayoho Jivattvam na sambhavati iti krutva. Because Jivattvam is not possible between a combination of Darpana and Adhishthana, being put together, a combination cannot become Jiva. Similarly, Adhishthana Chaitanya and Antakkaranam put together cannot be Jiva. Tasmad, therefore, Antakkaranam Tat Pratiphalita Chaitanya Bhasaha Tad Ubhaya Adhishthana Kutastha Chaitanyancha Iti Etat Trayamapi Militva Eva Jivaha Ityuchyate. So, who is Jiva finally? What we started with? Siddhanta is Antakkarana has to be there. Kutastha Chaitanya is anyway there. Because Isha Vasya Midam Sarvam. Kutastha Chaitanya is there everywhere. Chaitanya is there. Kutastha is a name given to an individualized. The presence in locality. Thereby, Kutastha Chaitanya is there. Antakkarana is there. Antakkarana has the capacity to reflect. Just like anything else. But Antakkarana has a specific capacity. Whereby this Pratiphalanam happens. Chaitanya Abhasa is possible, but for Abhasa to be possible with ownership, as with Tadatmya Sambandha, for Chaitanya to have Tadatmya Sambandha there, Kutastha Chaitanya to have identification with Antakkarana, becoming one, characteristics of the Antakkarana to be superimposed on Kutastha Chaitanya, and characteristics of Kutastha Chaitanya, characteristics and defining attributes, which are Satchidananda. We think the Antakkarana exists, that is the Sadaropa. We think that the Antakkarana is sentient, that is the Chidaropa. And then we think that the Ananda is there in Antakkarana, that is the Ananda Aropita there. Other way around, everything is there, you know, when we say that Antak, I am emotional, any kind of emotion, angry, I am, you know, happy, I am dukhi, there is Kama, I am Kami, all these ideas which come up in the Antakkarana, all those are Antakkarana attributes, those I superimpose upon myself. So there is Mishrana. So there is Adhyasa, which is both ways. That is called Tadatmya Sambandha. So, Antakkarana and Chaitanya Abhasa, when they come together, Antakkarana has some specific strength of attributes or behavior which is different from other Jada Vastus, where there can be identification and Swachhattvam is there. So, the Jiva or Chaitanya appears very clearly there. Therefore, there is confusion possible. If you see twins, you know, if you see twins, the parents can make them out, but we sometimes cannot make out. Same as twins. They are very close. How do you differentiate? Similarly, is this Abhasa, which comes up in the Antakkarana, we cannot differentiate. There is confusion. This is me. We lose sight of ourselves and we consider the other as me. It's like the one twin looking at the other and thinks that, you know, there is a mirror. There is no mirror. The other twin dressed up like this is standing in front. I mean, just some example to drive home the point that even the twin can get confused that I am seeing myself. No? Some idea there. So, tasmad antakaranam tat pratiphalana happens there. Antakarana and Chaitanya Abhasa put together, there is some pratiphalana. This is not, pratiphalana is not just pratibimba. Pratiphalana is that ending result which comes up in such a manner that choicelessly we become that as do. That is pratiphalana. Chaitanya comes alive there. That is the unholy combination and result which makes a person samsari. Tasmad antakaranam tat pratiphalita chaitanya abhasa tad ubhaya adhishthana kutastha chaitanyam. Kutastha chaitanya is there. There is pratiphalita chaitanya abhasa because antakarana is a particular type of reflecting medium. Etat trayam api militva eva jiva ityuchyate. That is the jiva. This is the jiva who we should understand as being talked about in Shastra. Till the jiva loses all the jivatva by bhagatyaga lakshana and becomes brahma as though figuratively jiva brahma eva naparaha. Tatra kutastasya samsara sambhava jiva eva samsari iti eshtavyam bhavati. Therefore, kutastasya samsara asambhava. Kutastha Chaitanya cannot be a samsari. Therefore, jiva eva samsari. Jiva is samsari, natu kutastha Chaitanya. Iti eshtavyam bhavati. This is what is a fact. Tatha panchadashyam uktam. So, panchadashikara, Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya says, Chaitanyam yadadishthanam linga dehaschayav punaha chichaya linga dehastha tatsango jiva uchyate iti. He says Chaitanyam. What is that Chaitanyam? Yad Adishthanam. So Adishthana Chaitanyam. Linga Deha cha. Linga Deha is what? Linga Deha is Sukshma Sharira, which is called as Antakkarana otherwise. Yaha Punaha. So Yaha Linga Deha cha. The Sukshma Sharira. Then what will happen? Chaitanya and Linga Deha come together. Sukshma Sharira comes together. Antakkarana will reflect. Pratibimba. Or will cause an abhasa. That abhasa can be called as chichaya or pratibimba also. He uses another word, chaya. Little chaya can go with abhasa also, pratibimba also. So chichaya that takes place in the linga deha. Linga dehastha chichaya. Linga dehastha. Linga dehe tishtati iti linga dehastha chichaya. Tatsango jiva uchyate. Tatsanga is all these three. So, all these three. Tesham sangha. So, bahuvachana. Because there are three. Chaitanya, which is kutastha chaitanya. Adishthana for linga deha. Sukshma sharira. And that sukshma sharira, chaitanya, plus the third entity being the chichaya, which is pratiphalita chaitanya. Pratiphalita chidabhasa. So, pratiphalita chidabhasa, all three put together. Tat sangha is tesham sangha e jiva uchyate. That is jiva. So, long tippana, we have finished. Now, let's go to the 188th avarta, which is abhasa swarupa vivechanam. So, viveka. Vivechana is viveka. Viveka of what? Abhasa swarupa. What is abhasa swarupa? Prak bimba rupa kutastha sahita chidabhaso jiva iti prapanchitam. So, we have gone ahead by looking at the Tippana. The Tippana has more information, looks ahead and gives. So, it helps us, although it is a little complex, it helps us to understand Mula, which is coming up as well. Prak Bimba Rupa Kutastha Sahita. The Kutastha, which is Bimba Rupa, Adishthana. Along with that, Chidabhasa is Jiva. And when you say Chidabhasa, Kutastha, bimba roopa kutastha chaitanya is there. When you say chidabhasa, where is this abhasa taking place? There has to be some upadhi. So it has what elaborated there. Ataha idam pratiyate. Now the analysis of that and the options are also given. Ata idam pratiyate. Buddhau pratiphalitaha yah pratibimbaha. So buddhau pratiphalita. Pratiphalana is what we saw just now. In buddhi. Buddhi is antakkarana. And specifically buddhi because upalabdhi sthana. Antakkarana plays four roles. In that the buddhi role is what makes the moksha also possible. Jnanotpatti is only in buddhi. So buddho pratiphalito yah pratibimbaha sa kutastasya eva. Whose pratiphalana is taking place in buddhi? One who is lelayati eva, jhayati eva, lelayati eva, says Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. That mimicker is kutastha. So kutastha follows as though by becoming pratiphala, pratiphalita chaitanya, chidabhasa. Chaitanya when pratiphalita will get another name, chidabhasa. So buddhau pratipalito yah pratibimbasya kutastasya eva natu bahya brahma chaitanyasya. Now a division is made. Kutastha is within. Kutavat tishtati iti kutastaha. That chaitanya who remains like a kuta, like an anvil. When an iron is shaped, the anvil remains as it is. Or like a heap. But the heap moves, you know. When there is a wind, the heap moves. So anvil is better. Comparatively. Anvil also, you know, it will also have some effect when banged upon, hit upon by the iron smith. But kutastha is there. Kutavat tishtati. As though unchanging. Not as though unchanging. Like as though an anvil is unchanging. Really anvil changes over a period of time. But if the comparison of the anvil not changing is with the iron which is beaten on it. So kutavat tishtati. Like the kuta. Not exactly like kuta. Something like kuta to drive home the point. In comparison to the iron which is beaten and shaped up. It's where it is beaten, the ground on it which is beaten, the thick iron piece, that does not change. Like that is this chaitanya, which is individualized. Thereby kutastha, kutastha seva pratibimbaha, natu bahya brahma chaitanyasya. Bahya brahma chaitanya, what is this? This is a total consciousness, brahma chaitanya. Brahma chaitanya itself gets the name of kutastha, but here we are making an analysis of jiva. There you cannot jump the gun and land on the conclusion. We have to hold on to the division like ghatakasha and mahakasha. While doing so, yasya pratibimbo anyatra pratiyate sayo bimba ityuchyate. What is bimba? Bimba, to identify bimba, who is this bimba? Bimba is kutastha, not bahya brahma chaitanya. For that we have to understand the definition of bimba. Bimba definition is what? Yasya pratibimbo anyatra pratiyate. Bimba, the original image which reflects, or original face. Let's say the face is reflecting. We don't need to say original face because face is face. The face or the person is bimba. The reflection is in the mirror. Now when the reflection takes place, that time is the reflection where the face is or where the person is the reflection there itself? No, the reflection is elsewhere. So that is the definition of bimba. Yasya pratibimba. In the case of the example, yasya purushasya pratibimbaha anyatra darpanau. Darpane pratiyate. So the pratibimba appears in darpana, which is anyatra, from where the person is standing. So yasya purushasya pratibimba anyatra pratiyate sa purusha, that person eva bimba ityuchyate. In the exemplified, what will happen? Prakrute, in the exemplified in the context, kutastasya bimbatvangi karat jivaha tat pratibimba ityeva pratiyate. what is the conclusion that appears from this example in the context? Kutastha is the bimba. Bimbatva angikara. What will happen? Jivaha tat pratibimba iti eva pratiyate. Jivaha is the pratibimba of kutastha. Tat is kutastha. Kutastha. Jiva tat pratibimba means jiva is kutastha pratibimba iti eva pratiyate. So who is jiva? He is the combination we have seen. But in the combination, adhishtana chaitanyam kim? Adhishtana chaitanyam is kutastha chaitanyam, natu bahya chaitanyam. Bahya brahma chaitanyam na. Tathahi atyantara, atyanta rakta japa kusumat yupadhi uparistha swachas phatike tat pushpadi raktima pratiyate. Now, the upadhi is being explained here. Atyanta rakta japakusuma. Japakusuma is the flower. That flower, which is atyanta rakta, meaning deep red. Upadhi upari. Upadhi upari stha. Swachaspatike. So this swachaspatika, on this upadhyuparistha swachaspatike, let's say this patika is kept above the flower. Maybe not touching, above in the sense, just a little above, and below there is a flower. Or imagine that there is a spatika linga and the flower is being offered. This flower is, japakusuma is offered, which is deep red in color. It is not touching the Shivlinga, which is made of spatika. It is just near at its feet, as though at the bottom. In that case, what happens is tat pushpadi raktima pratiyate kutra swachas patike. In that swachas patika, which was clear so far, if you put a flower, offer a flower, that flower's redness, deep red color of the flower, is seen in the crystal. The crystal assumes the red color. You assume the red color of the crystal because the crystal appears red. The crystal is not red. Such as patikadi gata raktima tat pushpadi pratibimba eva. So, why is the crystal appearing red? It has taken the pratibimba. It is the pratibimba of the pushpa. Pushpadi adipadana, something else also. You offer a, put a blue cloth there, the blue cloth will also be seen. The blueness of the cloth somehow is seen in the crystal. Tatha kutasthashrita buddhau kutasthasya prakasha pratiphalati. Therefore, kutastha is nearby. There, individualized. Therefore, kutastha ashrita buddhau. Buddhi is placed on kutastha. Sorry, kutastha ashrita buddhau. Yeah, buddhi is. In the example, it is other way around. Here it is. Buddhi has ashraya in kutastha. Kutasthasya prakasha pratiphalati kutra buddhau. In the buddhi, kutastha shines up. Pratiphalati. So there is a, actually in the example also, what has been said, it's the other way around here. Just like the, so here the, pratiphalana is being explained. So it is like the example. This upadhi, redness being an upadhi, is an example used elsewhere also. You must have studied in other granthas. It is used for sharira as upadhi, buddhi as upadhi. Here what is being shown is that in the buddhi, for pratiphalana, there is an example used. Same example is used. So therefore, example, in the example, what has been said? The one that borrows, one that borrows the attributes as though, is placed on the flower. Similarly here, buddhi is as though placed on the kutastha and it borrows the kutastha's prakasha. Kutasthasya prakasha pratiphalati. Sa prakasha eva chidabhasa ityuchyate. That is called a chidabhasa. There is a tippana here. Pata विलक्षणत्वे सति पटवद् भासमानत्वं पटाभासत्वं यथा। सो तर्का इज गिवन देयर, पट विलक्षणत्वे सति पटवद् भासमानत्वं, सॉरी पट पटवद् भासमानत्वं पट पट आभासत्वं। पटाभास इज डिफाइंड, व्हाट इज पटाभास? पट विलक्षणत्वे सति, बीइंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम पट मीनिंग अ क्लॉथ, पटवद् भासमानत्वं। सो इफ यू टेक इन द एग्जांपल आल्सो, इन द एग्जांपल ऑफ स्फटिका, इज स्फटिका द क्लॉथ? इट इज नॉट द क्लॉथ, बट स्फटिका विच इज केप्ट ऑन द क्लॉथ, I'm just giving, extending this example. There is a red cloth. Somebody, blue cloth, let's say. Red, we have taken the flower. Let's differentiate. There is a blue cloth. Somebody points out, look at that blue thing. You are looking at the crystal. The person is showing the blue cloth. Look at that beautiful blue. The blue is the color of the cloth. The person who is showing it is the cloth. But you see the blueness in the crystal and you say, oh, he is talking about the blue crystal. So the blue crystal, spatika, is not really blue. Of course, it is not pata also, but I am just extending to the only looking at the color part. So pata vilakshanatve sati pata vad bhasamanattvam. It is different from the pata, but appears like the pata. Does not appear like the cloth, but the blueness shows the similarity. Patabhas, patabhasattvam yatha, that is patabhasa. Similarly, tatha chit vilakshanatve sati chidvat bhasamanattvam chidabhasattvam. So chidabhasa is what? Chidvat bhasamanattvam. Appears like chit, but is not chit. That is chidabhasa. So chidabhasa ityuchyate saprakasha eva, that prakasha which is the Pratibimba. So look at this. Pratibimba and Abhasa have been explained in the same sentence, in the same prakriya rather. Pratibimba vada, Abhasa vada, not much difference. We have seen the intricacies earlier. Let those intricacies be. But here you look at it, Ghatakasha, Pataka, Mahakasha, all these have been used in the example. Pratibimba is talked about and Abhasa is also talked about in the same. So the strengths of all three vadas have been put together by Bhagavan Panchadashikara in the sixth chapter. Similarly here, Sadhu uses those. He says it's a very good way. You don't have to differentiate between one vada and the other. You use the strength of all three, combine it and try to get to the Siddhanta. Why do you keep on bickering about which is right, which is better? That can be there at the Tarka level to sharpen your buddhi. But can you use the positives of all, pros of all vadas and land on a very good systematic approach to result in Aikya Siddhi, Advaita Siddhi? Use it. So Chidabhasa has been defined as Prakasha. Atyanta Swachcha Sphatika Vat Buddhi Api Atyanta Nirmala. So Sphatika and Buddhi have a similarity. Both are Atyanta Swachcha. Sattva guna, buddhi is a result of sattva guna, karya. Sattva guna karyatva tasyaha, tasyaha buddhehe. Buddhi is a result of sattva guna, karya, result as in it's a product or an effect of sattva guna. Sattva guna is its karana. It is created through sukshma sattva guna and becomes the karya as buddhi. And similarity of atyanta satchatvam is there. Because sattva is such svachatvam, has svachatvam rather. Tatra pratiphalita kutastha prakashasyeva pratibimba iti samakhya. So pratiphalita kutastha, who is prakasharupa, also called as chidabhasa, that chidabhasa itself has another name. Samakhya is what? Pratibimba iti. So pratibimba and chidabhasa are interchangeable words. Or pratiphalita Kutastha Prakasha is Chidabhasa and another name is Pratibimba. Buddhe Kutastha Adishthita. Sorry, Buddhehe Kutastha Adishthitatvad Buddhav Kutastha Seva Pratibimba Uchita Iti Jeeva Kutastha Pratibimba Iti Paksha Pradarshita. So one option has been presented. Paksha is an option now. There can be another also. Kutastha adhishthitatvat buddhehe. Because buddhi rests in kutastha, rests in a superimposed, kalpita. Other words, whatever is comfortable, you can use that word. Buddhi is adhyasa, adhyarupita, adhyaropya, kalpita also, whichever word suits. Where, what is the adhishthana? Adhishthana is near, that happens to be kutastha chaitanya. Therefore, buddhau kutastha seva prativimba uchita iti, jiva kutastha prativimba iti paksha pradarshita. What does this mean? Natu brahma chaitanya, bahya brahma chaitanya na, because bahya brahma chaitanya is not the adhishthana for buddhi. Buddhis are many. Therefore, you have to have individualized consciousness as the substratum that happens to be kutastha chaitanya. That is pradarshitaha. Now, next is what? Athava brahma chaitanyasya buddhau pratibimba iti pakshopi sambhavyate eva. We'll look at this paksha in the, yeah, this is a long one. So, we look at this in the next part. We'll break here. Athava. So, another possibility is brahma chaitanya being the adhishtana. This we'll look at in the next part. Sukham nityam saprakasham vyapakam nama rupi adhishtanam buddhya bodhyam buddhya dhrityatna nirmana aparam sarva vedanta vedyam pratyak paramaha tadevahnam atto nirviti menishchita matihi. Tatsat. Any questions? Namaste.
Hari Om.